Y'all look good. Y'all look good. Amen. Yeah. Awesome, awesome. We got a spot right here, too. From somebody want to be on the white carpet? Yeah, it's up to you. Yeah. Husband on the red. Okay. Husband on the red. Wife on the white. Yeah. Do we have enough? I think we have a few more. Can we, yeah, we can have a few come on the stage. Do we have any extra red hearts? Or if not, y'all can come up here and we can put two.
I think
we
got enough. We got just enough out.
Just enough. Thank you,
wow.
Lord. Amen.
Look at the Holy Ghost.
Yeah. This was purpose. Amen. Just enough. We need one more. Okay.
We need two more.
Come on up here.
Y'all can come up here with us.
Yeah, we can have y'all over here. And the Franklin. Okay. Y'all can come over here on the stage as well. Leroy? Yeah, you here?
Deborah.
And Deborah across from you. Yeah, that's beautiful. Just like that.
And everybody, you should be receiving some communion as well as a prayer for the spouse for your husband and your wife. They're getting those out to you now, so give us just a moment as they prepare it.
Okay. Are there any others? I don't want to rush this moment. Can you pull the drum back or pull it down a little, Chris?
Yeah.
Give me some. I don't want it to feel rushed. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. All right. Okay. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you all. Amen. We want y'all to lock in. We want y'all to fully connect. We want you to embrace this moment. Amen. Because I believe God is going to do something new. He's going to do something special in all of our lives. God loves marriage. God loves union. He loves togetherness. He loves what he has put together.
Yeah.
And he says simply, what I have put together, let no man put asunder. So Father God, we come before you right now as husband and as wife. We surrender and we submit our life to you first and foremost. We're married to you and you're married to us.
Yes, God.
And you have afforded us the ability to be married to each other. So Father God, we take this moment seriously. We thank you for allowing us to come together and to share the love and the laughter and the life that you have called us to have. I thank you, Lord God, for that which you have started, because you're faithful to finish it right now in the name of Jesus. And Father God, we surrender our life and we surrender our will and we surrender our way so that we can be one in you.
Yes, Lord.
So Father God, we put our mind, we put our heart on one another right now. And we thank you for what you're about to do. Today, two shall become one in you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Many people believe that entering into marriage is the final step in the romantic relationship. As they see it, a couple meets, gets to know each other, falls in love, decides they want to go through life together, and then take the final step in marriage. But marriage is not meant to be the final step in a couple's relationship. It really is just the beginning of a covenant. that hopefully will be long fruitful for each and every one of us.
Yes.
We all have shared the many joys. We've shared the blessings. We've shared challenges. We've shared the married life for many years. And today, we wish to reconfirm your commitment to working together to make your marriage grow and blossom in the years to come. May this ceremony of renewing your vows you took to become husband and wife on your wedding day remind you that despite the stresses inevitable in every life, your love, respect, trust, and understanding of each other will continue to increase as the days go by. Can you please join hands? Yeah. Husband, can you repeat after me with thy will? Will you continue to have her as your wife and to continue to love her in this marriage? Amen. Do you reaffirm your love for her and will love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, in richer or poorer, for better or worse, and forsaking all others? Be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. Amen. Wives, look your man of God in the eye. Will you continue to have him as your husband and continue to love him in this marriage? Do you reaffirm your love for him? And will you love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, and forsaking all others? Be faithful to him as long as you both shall live. Amen. At this moment, we're going to pause for the husbands to read the prayer over their wife, and for the wife to read the prayer over their husband.
Amen.
At this time, we're going to seal our vows with communion. This communion is a sign of covenant, the covenant that God has with his people. He says that he will never leave us nor forsake us. He says that he will come, he will save us, he will rescue us, he will be there with us forever. And it is symbolic of the marriage and the union that we have with Christ, where he says, I love you, I will be there for you, I will never leave you, I love you. So let's lift up the body that which represents Christ. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our well-being was upon him. With his stripes, we are healed. And it is also a representation of how we as husbands, we can allow healing to flow in the life of our spouse. No matter what the issue is, no matter whether it's unforgiveness or unfaithfulness or any struggle, healing can take place in our relationship.
Yes, God.
So, Father God, we receive your body, which is a representation of your healing virtue that you've given toward us, and we will now give it toward our spouse. Let's receive his body in Jesus' name. Let's lift up the blood, which is a sign of God's blood covenant toward us. His blood, it washes, his blood purifies, his blood, it erases the stain of sin. And Father God, we thank you for your blood, and as a representation of your blood, we also, as husbands, give our wife purity, cleaning, the ability to wash things that was done away in the name of Jesus. And Father God, we thank you for your blood that is precious, and we gladly receive it. And just as you don't hold any sin against us, today we will relinquish anything that was done between the husband and wife right now in the name of Jesus. We let go unforgiveness. We let go bitterness. We let go strife. We let go envy. We let go mistrust. We let go pride, anger, in Jesus' name. Let's receive his blood. First Corinthians 13 and 4 says, love endures and is kind. Love is not envious. It's not jealous. Love wants not for itself. Love is not puffed up, nor does it behave wrongly. Love seeks not for its own will. Love is not easily provoked. Love is not rude. Love thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in wrong, but dwells in truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things. Love never fails. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for our spouse. We thank you for our loved one. We thank you, Lord, for that which you have bound together. Lord God, we will be better. We will be unified. Yes, we will, Lord, have oneness of mind, oneness of thinking, oneness of doing, oneness of being. We will be on one mind, one accord. We will love one another with the agape love of God, the unconditional love, non-judgmental love, the love that heals, the love that restores, the love that renews. And Father God, we thank you for our most prized investment here on this earth. and that is our spouse. And we thank you for allowing us to be grace to live these days that we have with each other. And we give you the praise, honor, and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. And it is with pleasure that I conclude this ceremony of the renewing of the vows of marriage that join you and bind you as husband and wife. Please celebrate the renewal of vows with a kiss. Please salute one another. Let's give each other, let's give God some praise, and let's love on one another, and let's celebrate. We thank God, amen, for our spouse. We thank God for, amen, reaffirming this union. Amen.
God is good.